When the news broke in the U.S. that the Soviets had installed an SS-4 ICBM missile with a range of 1,100 miles that could reach most U.S. cities, the American public was totally shocked because they had no knowledge of all the surveillance we had done for months before. Well, the flight was flown by Heiser. He took off from Edwards just after midnight on the 14th. Flew over Corpus Christi and then the point east where he turned due north to this 10-minute run over the island where we had discovered all these SAMs. And as we expected, the first intercontinental missile was discovered on that flight. Kennedy's staff was almost equally divided as to the half that wanted to knock the missiles out immediately and the other half that wanted to use diplomacy. And the Army, Navy, Air Force, and the Marines were all at a very high state of readiness. And there were several wings of fighter planes deployed to Florida to be real close to these missiles if they needed to be. Seven messages exchanged between President Kennedy and Khrushchev. And Khrushchev's messages were very angry sounding and very terse. And he didn't sound like he was going to move those missiles for a time. And so for a whole week there, I thought any day we were going to go to war. It was that close. We were really threatened. And we had every reason to go to war because our country was really threatened. But fortunately, we didn't.